गुड मॉर्निंग व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ एस्ट्रोलॉजर अनिल अग्रवाल। यू सी, टुडे वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्लैनेटरी पोजीशंस एंड स्पेशली एज आई हैव मेंशनड दैट यू नो द चार्ट्स ऑफ नरेंद्र मोदी आर नॉट ऑथेंटिक, सो आई हैव यूज्ड द ओथ चार्ट एंड एज पर द ओथ चार्ट दे आर मोस्ट मैलिफिक कॉम्बिनेशंस। यू नो इन द नवामशा देयर इज Rahu and Ketu in the 1-7 axis and Sun, Jupiter and Mercury are afflicted in the chart. Mars is placed in the 4th house in the Navamsha in the sign Aquarius, and on the 10th of May when Ketu will leave the Jyeshtha Nakshatra, you see what happens when a planet is about to leave, change Nakshatra, change sign. It is most important. So it the maximum energy is the whole energy is concentrated at that point of time. And unfortunately, in the O chart of Narendra Modi, the Rahu Ketu axis, the Scorpio Lagna is rising, where the fallen planet is there in the D1, and in the Navamsha. In the Navamsha, there is Ketu. In the sign Scorpio, although the Lagna is Vargottam, it is auspicious, but the problem is that there is Ketu, and what do you call, then in the 7th house there is Rahu and Sun. See, let me just read, let me see what are the planetary positions so that I am able to explain them better. You see, in the Navamsha chart, there is Saturn, Venus and Ketu in the Lagna, and in the 7th house, Sun and Rahu. Now, what is happening? On the 10th of May, Rahu and Ketu are changing Navamsha, and Rahu is in Taurus and Ketu is in Scorpio, and in Navamsha also, Ketu will be in Scorpio and Rahu will be in Taurus, and they will be afflicting the 1-7 axis, and the Jupiter will also be afflicted there. Let me tell you which all planets are afflicted there. Sun, Jupiter, Ketu are in Scorpio, and Rahu and Mercury are in Taurus, and Mars and Venus are in the 4th house. Mars will be over the natal Mars. You know, it is said that in the Varga charts, if the 1-7 axis are afflicted by Rahu and Ketu, then the significations of that Varga suffers and there is stress and strain. So it clearly points out that after now these, they will remain in this axis till 20th of August. It clearly, crystal clear, indicates that is a time of agony and pain for the Prime Minister and the country as well. Although Ketu will leave the Jyeshtha Nakshatra, but it will not leave the sign Scorpio. Mind you, I had already mentioned that till the time Ketu leaves the sign Scorpio, we will not get any major relief from the coronavirus. Now, it shows that the axis, as far as the India Foundation chart is also concerned, the 1-7 axis is Taurus and Scorpio. If you look at the Pisces New Moon chart, the axis is Taurus and Scorpio. And in Navamsha also, Rahu and Ketu comes. So, this will be time for agony and pain. Although Ketu will leave, that Nakshatra is a big relief. But mind you, it does not mean that the number of coronavirus cases will come down. There is Veda between Mars and Saturn till the 16th of May, and Mars will be aspecting Saturn by 8th aspect till 2nd of June. And friends, this is another parameter which we have not discussed, is that the Venus ingress in the sign Gemini is most malefic and venomous. But it is, we cannot say it will act as a catalyst for their diseases. But as far as the political scenario of the country is concerned, it is definitely not good. Because then the parameters which are bad are, first of all, Saturn in Shravana Nakshatra and in the sign Capricorn, where the minimum Ashtakvarga Bindus are there. They are minimum 18 Vinashtakvarga Bindus. I have been talking about it since long, and in all my articles I have mentioned. And the second house is Gemini, which is also weak and which has only Vinashtakvarga of 19. And Mars is already transiting there. And ever since Mars has transited there, it has created emergency-like situations. Not that Venus going there will create more havoc. Mars has already done it. Venus will only, you know, prolong it. So some of the astrologers are saying that after Venus going in Gemini, the disease will increase. I do not know why did not they predict before that when Mars went in Gemini, that was the time for maximum chaos and emergency-like situations. And we have seen all that after the 24th April, after the 24th April, as mentioned by me, because there is Veda between Mars and Saturn in the Rashi Nakshatra Sangata Chakra, 24th is the time when Mars entered in Ardra. Sorry, Mars activated the great conjunction of Saturn and Jupiter, which took place on the 21st of December 2021. And as per Brit Samhita, you know, it brings a phenomenal change and it is time for disaster. So friends, people are doing post-mortem, and this is not good. Predictions should be made prior to all the happenings. And now they are having second thoughts. And then some astrologers have also started talking about a fallen planet, which they never talked about it. So I'm surprised. Okay. Anyway, the basic point is that the Rahu Ketu changing Navamsha and the Rahu Ketu in the 1-7 axis of the old chart of Narendra Modi will be most enigmatic, and this is not a good time even for the country. The number of cases, as I've already mentioned, till 16th will be most venomous. The number of cases per day as far as coronavirus is concerned, I've already mentioned from 24th to 16th, and then on 23rd Saturn is getting stationary. It gets stationary 5 days before, so 18th of May, and then it will be having degree aspect when it is stationary. Degree aspect of Mars, it is not good, friends. So untoward happenings. So the grace will be that Ketu will leave Jastha Nakshatra, and as I have mentioned, the world most tragic events happened when malefics are there in the Jastha star, and Ketu leaving that star as per true motion. I am taking as per true motion. Probably it could also affect as per the mean motion, but I don't consider mean motion. I take true motion, because all the planets, we take the true motion of all the planets, so we are bound to take for Rahu also. And whenever Rahu will be in adverse motion, as I have mentioned, in the month of May and June, it will be for number of days Rahu will be in adverse motion, so it can give spikes for the coronavirus in the month of May and June, especially Rahu goes in adverse motion. Now Rahu, it was adverse motion till the 5th, and it has the capacity to change the trend. As I've said, it is unexpected. It can turn the tables upside down, and we have seen the number of cases were 4,02,000, then it went to 4,386, then 358, then again they have gone to 4,12,000 and 4,14,000. It is basically because of Rahu. But by and large, my feeling is that now till the 13th, Rahu is in normal motion. So probably the maybe the number of cases remain same, around 4,12,000, 4,14,000. They may not go up, but definitely after the 10th, my feeling is that after the 10th, there may be some reduction. Definitely there has to be reduction after the 10th of May. But on the 13th of May, from 13th of May to 21st of May, Rahu is again in forward motion, so it can again give spikes. And then from 26th May, Rahu is again in adverse motion, till the first week of June. And in June, because we have the solar eclipse, so irrespective whether the eclipse is visible in India or not, but Rahu will be in forward motion for a number of days. So there can be spikes as far as coronavirus is concerned, even in June. But my feeling is that the top, whatever figure is there for the coronavirus, till the 10th of May, it may not cross after the 10th of May. And till 16th is also a very crucial day, because again, Mars and Saturn, there is a Veda, and Mars will be aspecting degree-wise Saturn. So 16th till 16th is the most critical time, and also emergency-like situations. I have also already mentioned emergency-like situation from the 24th to 16th of May, which has proved spot on. Not even a single astrologer pointed out these dates. Now, talking about Venus, which creates a political turmoil in the country when it goes in the sign Gemini. This article, I have written so many articles on this, especially at the time of the actor, Sushant Singh Rajput. Venus was in Gemini, and we have seen the type of turmoils what we have gone through. It may not affect the disease, but definitely it will affect the political scenario of the country. And Venus will join Gemini on the 28th of May, 28th of May to 22nd of June. So even if I take that Venus will influence the pandemic or the COVID, then it cannot, the number of cases will not go beyond whatever figure we have till 10th of May, because Ketu is the planet for disease and Venus is not the planet for disease. Mind you, people are confusing, the astrologers are confusing. Ketu is the main planet. There is a saying, Sura Suram, Rahu Rog Harnam, Ketu Rog Karnam. Rahu is Amrit, and Ketu, because it is the lower portion and it has no head, so Ketu is disease karka, and Rahu is not disease karka. Rahu becomes disease karka when he is in adverse motion. So that is why I am saying that when Rahu will be in adverse motion, it can act as a disease karka, it can act as a poison. That is why at that point of time there can be spikes. But the controller for disease is Ketu, and it is not Venus. Venus may become weak, the Lagna Lord and the Sikh Lord may become weak, but it cannot give you disease. Disease giving planet is Ketu. So, and Ketu will go in Anuradha star, and Anuradha, Lord of Anuradha will be Saturn. It will go in retrogression. It is not good on the 23rd of May, and things may, the coronavirus may be just like a hanging fire, as I've already predicted, especially till from 2nd of June to 20th of July. And then the third wave, as I've already mentioned, from the 14th of September to 20th of November, the most enigmatic time as far as Jupiter is concerned. And Jupiter will be fallen, it will be retrograde, it will be debilitated, and it will meet Saturn for the third time. And it is not good. See, you see, and as far as Narendra Modi's OS chart is concerned, Arudhi Lagna is Capricorn and Chhatra Rashi is Aquarius. So the moment Jupiter leaves Aquarius will be the time for trouble, agony and pain again from the 14th of September to 20th of November. So this is, friends, this is all I just wanted to share, that till 16th of May, definitely the time is most critical for coronavirus. And my feeling is that after 10th of May, because the number of cases may go up, and because the number of cases will go up, we will have to implement lockdowns. The node changing their Namamsha and coming in the 1-7 axis of the India Foundation chart, and also the Pisces New Moon chart, and also the Oath chart of the Prime Minister, and also the Oath chart of Arvind Kejriwal. So all this Taurus Scorpio axis will be under acute affliction, because Rahu and Ketu in D1 will also be in Taurus Scorpio axis, and in Navamsha also they will be in that axis till 20th of August. So till 20th of August, coronavirus can remain as a hanging fire. But it does not mean that Ketu leaving the just the star will not give us some respite. It will definitely give some respite, but a slow respite. First of all, Ketu leaves Jyestha Nakshatra, then the Veda between Mars and Saturn breaks after 16th is the most critical day. Again, I'm telling you, I had already mentioned that the two dates, 24th, 25th April and 16th May, are most venomous, because the Saturn and Mars degree aspect, Mars aspect degree wise on Saturn is most critical, and it is also not good for terrorism in the country. As I mentioned, the moment Mars goes in Cancer and it will be in 1-7 axis with Saturn, it will activate so many, the Mars of so many countries. As I mentioned, the Jammu and Kashmir is most prone state, and it has Saturn and Mars together, and Mars activating the Mars in the 7th house of wars, there could be terrorism there. And 9th house, Saturn is transiting in the 9th house of the India Foundation chart. Communalism, you know, communal rights can also take place. Rights in what sense? You know, people may get disgusted. People may get disgusted. The masses may get disgusted because of coronavirus spreading and not giving any ease. So because of that also, and there could be some troubles. So friends, this is all I just wanted to share, that any event in the life of the native or the nation, and especially like oath taking, is most important, and you can make any predictions according to that. And according to this only, I had predicted that there will be riots on the 23rd of February 2020, when Donald Trump visited India. And I still remember, I had written on the Facebook that if Donald Trump knew astrology, he wouldn't have visited India. So in any case, the predictions are coming, proving spot on from the oath chart of Narendra Modi. And more to say, the Pisces New Moon chart, which is having Angarak Yoga in the Lagna, and the Lord of the Year is also Mars, will trouble. Definitely it will trouble till the time it goes in the sign Leo. It can create havoc. So, and the coronavirus can be a hanging fire. In any case, as I have told you, till the time Ketu leaves the sign Scorpio and Mars reaches 180 degrees from the Angarak Yoga, that is, it crosses Scorpio and reaches Sagittarius on the 18th January 2022, and then Ketu leaves Scorpio on the 17th March 2022, and when Rahu and Ketu also, they have exchange in Nakshatras on the 7th and 8th February 2023, and then finally when Saturn also leaves the sign Capricorn on the 29th April 2023, we will see the coronavirus to disappear. Why I'm giving you all these dates is totally on the basis of Spanish flu, and I find absolutely parallel planetary positions taking place like the Spanish flu. The Spanish flu, at the time of Spanish flu, there was a Angarak Yog in the sign Scorpio where Rahu was there. Now, the Angarak Yog is in the sign Taurus, 180 degrees from that. And after Mars had transited, had gone in Gemini at that time, then there was some relief. So similarly, I would say when Mars goes in the sign Sagittarius, we will get some relief. And Mars in a fiery sign is very good for relief. And I have used the D6, D8 charts, which no astrologers has used. And the other thing is, I have used the Gulika, the Mrityusputa, Dehspputa, Pranchputa. Not even a single astrologer has used all these parameters, which is of prime importance for delineating any disease. And people are talking, they are using Pluto and all that. They are giving their new theories. I don't know. We are getting derailed from the basic concept of disease. First of all, the basic concept should be seen, then any other concept should be seen. So this is all, friends, I just wanted to share that astrology is most amazing, and you can predict anything, and you will see that from after the 10th of May, you will definitely get some relief, and especially after the 16th, and then after the 2nd June, and then 20th June, and then 20th August, and then 20th November, and then 18th January 2022, and then 17th March 2022, we will see a substantial relief. Although the coronavirus will hang over, it will be hanging, still a hanging fire, but because of the advancement in medical science and vaccines, we may get some relief, but it will still remain till 7th and 8th of February and 29th April 2023. So friends, thank you for listening to me. Have a good day, and best of luck.